Hello students, today we will learn about Dijkstra algorithm. Introduction. Dijkstra algorithm, derived by a Dutch computer scientist Edgar Wybie Dijkstra in 1956 and published it in 1959. Dijkstra algorithm. Dijkstra algorithm is a solution to the single source shortest path problem in graph theory. It works on both directed and undirected graphs. However, all edges must have non-negative weights. It follows the approach of greedy method. Input to the Dijkstra algorithm is weighted graph G equal to EV, where E is a number of edges and V is a set of vertices and source vertex such that all edge weights are non-negative. Output, length of shortest path given from a source vertex to all other vertices present in a graph. How it works? This algorithm finds the path with lowest cost, that is the shortest path between that vertex and every other vertex. For example, if the vertex of the graph represents cities and edge path cost represent driving distance between pairs of cities connected by a direct road. Dijkstra algorithm can be used to find the shortest route between one city and the other cities. Dijkstra algorithm example. Here we are given with a directed graph. Each edge have a certain weight that is non-negative, and we have to find the distance of all other vertex from the vertex A. For the initialization of the graph, we will assign a certain distance to each vertex from A. Initially, none of the vertex has been visited, so all other vertex other than A, we will assign a distance of infinity and zero to the node itself. So, if A is a starting vertex, A will be assigned with zero distance and B, C, D and E vertex have the infinity distance in the starting. S is a subset of vertices that has been visited while traversing the all nodes from a starting node. First, we will visit the starting node. Here, A is a starting node. That's why S contain only A node. When we have visited A node, we will put the distance to all other vertices that is having direct contact, means direct edge from A. Here B and C is having direct edge from A and each node having weight 10 and 3 respectively. So now infinity weight of B and C is replaced by 10 and 3 in a graph. Now we have to find the next vertex that can be visited from A. Vertex B have 10 distance, C have 3 distance and D and E have infinity distance from A. Out of these 3 is a minimum distance, so we will select next node that can be visited is C. So S will contain A and C now. When C is visited, we can now add the distance of C to the direct edge vertices it is having. C is having in direct contact with B, D and E. So we will update the distance of these nodes respectively. Now B can have 3 plus 4. That is 7 weight, 3 is the weight of C and 4 is a weight for going from C to B. Similarly, weight of D can be updated from infinity to 11. 3 plus 8 equal to 11. Similarly, weight of 3 can be updated. 3 plus 2, that is 5. Now we have to select the next node that can be visited. B is having weight 7, D is having weight 11 and E is having weight 5. Out of these minimum is 5, so So the next node that can be visited is E. So S will contain A, C and E. Each time we have to choose the minimum weight, because in Dijkstra algorithm we have to find the minimum distance from one node to all other nodes present. While visiting E, E is having direct edge to a single vertex, that is D. If we calculate the weight of D via E, it will come out to be 5 plus 9, which is greater than the already present weight of D, that is 11. So we will not update the weight of D because we have to choose the minimum weight. Now we have to find the next node that can be visited. B is having weight 7 and D is having weight 11. Out of these two, 7 is minimum. So the next node is B that have to be visited. So it will get added in a list of S. Now S will contain A, C, E and B. B is having direct edge to D and C. C is already visited, so there is no need to update the weight of C. Now we have to update the weight of B. While calculating the weight of D, B itself is having weight 7 plus 2, that is distance from B to D is 2. So 7 plus 2 equal to 9. So we will update the weight of D as 9 instead of 11. Only node D is remain unvisited in a graph. So we will include D in S. Now all the nodes of a graph is present in S, and we can calculate the minimum distance from A to all other nodes. A, C, E, B, D. This is a minimum path that one have to follow to reach from node A to all other vertex. Dijkstra algorithm work in this manner only. Implementation and runtime. The simplest implementation is to store vertices in an array or linked list. This will produce a running time of big O of V square plus E. For graph with very few edges and many nodes, it can be implemented more efficiently, storing the graph in an adjacency list using a binary heap or priority queue. This will produce a running time of big O of E plus V log V. Application of Dijkstra algorithm. First, it is used in traffic information systems. Second, mapping. Third, routing systems. Thank you.